acid. A stands for atomicity. C stands for consistency. I stands for isolation. And D stands for durability. So in the coming to the atomicity, both the users, either the transaction should be complete or it must not be completed. We will say as either all of one. So user A. User A is having 10,000 rupees and user B is having 5,000 rupees. When we come to the atomicity, here user A wants to give 2,000 rupees to user B. Now the amounts at user A are 8,000 and at user B are 7,000. So here the transaction is totally complete and the amounts are correctly transferred from user A account to user B account. So here the transaction has satisfied the atomicity property. Coming to the second property, and next is consistency. Consistency means the transaction, the total amount before and after transaction should be same. So before the transaction, we have seen that user A has 10,000 and user B has 5,000. So the total amount is 15,000 before the transaction. Coming after transaction, user A is having 8,000 and user B is having 7,000. Now the total amount is 15,000. So consistency is also satisfied. Coming to the third property, isolation. Isolation means two transactions take place separately. So here, with the help of the lock, we are going to the transaction is going to take place. So user A transfers 2,000 rupees to user B's account. So the exclusive lock is activated by user A. This is the exclusive lock. And next, after the transfer of amount, the user B is having 9,000. And the lock is given to user B. So the isolation property is also satisfied. Next, coming to the fourth property, final one is durability. So the transaction data, which is 6,000 and 9,000 with respect to users A and D, is stored at the server. This is how the transaction takes place using the four ASIC properties. Thank you.